Frisco Lacrosse and Frisco Fury have been perennial favorites in the Texas State Tournament. In 2019, they earned a shot at the title game against their crosstown rivals, the Southlake Dragons. In a controversial victory that saw several of the Frisco star players red-carded and thusly playing without a midfield line, the Frisco Fury somehow took the game to overtime. In the final seconds of sudden-death overtime, Southlake's stellar attacker went one-on-one with Frisco's defender. The game did not go in Frisco's favor. This is a story of redemption. Kayla Kempsey was born to be on the grass field. A draw control specialist and a four-year starter at Syracuse under Gary Gates. Claire McCain, four-year player for the University of Colorado Buffaloes, heads the defensive unit. With the collective unsettled business, there's a lot riding on the 2020 season. You ain't got no money, I ain't got no time. All these faces looking funny when I'm driving by. Head to 10 mile with my name is Buzzin. No, they plan on killing mine. Name it that your temple, we were taught to kill a nine mine. Blood is sitting in my hands. I'll never be the bigger man. I know they'll never understand, but they don't give a fuck. Lift your hands up high before I stick you up. Yeah. Kempsey, McCain, and team have successfully developed college-recruited athletes in number 2, Zoe McElhaney, number 21, Bella Fiacconi, Venny McDaniel, and tonight they celebrate their collective success.
I'm super humble and grateful for this opportunity and just seeing my journey, that like how far and how much time it took to get here, and it's just really incredible because I can be a little aggressive sometimes, but I can also be lifting up the team. My strongest aspect would probably be my aggression and just determination, and my worst would probably be my attitude.
Cool to see everybody else get recognized for playing on the next level, and I thought it was even cooler to be one of the representing Frisco lacrosse girls that has been the first to sign at a Frisco ISD thing. So I thought that was really cool, and I loved being around Benny and Zoe and everybody else that was signing, and I saw a lot of my friends there that were signing for other things too, so it was a good time.
I really want us to work as hard as we did last year to go to state. It's going to be a lot harder this year with all the D1 teams, so we're definitely going to have to work a lot harder together and find that connection again that we had last year because of all the new players that we have on the team. So, yeah, just focus on our connection with each other.
For me, the brand is more of like family to me. Like, I've literally grown up with all of my teammates, all of, like, the senior girls. Everyone around me has been in my life since, like, third grade. So, to me, the brand of the team is literally, like, a family. Like, I can go to anyone on the team about anything.
Opening the 2020 season at the newly minted Rockwall Varsity program, both the team and the weather showed up. In sleeting 32-degree weather, Frisco had their challenges. Run through, come on!
I know it's cold. You guys knew it was cold ahead of time. You chose chose not to wear gloves, you chose not to put latex gloves underneath, you chose not to wear leggings or a headband. I don't want to hear if you're cold. What are you complaining about today? This is our first game of the season. We have a lot to prove right here. This team, this is their first year as a varsity program. All right, you guys should do the fundamentals correctly and easily handle this team. All right, defense, as long as you're communicating, playing with your feet, we should not be giving them 8 meters. But you need to play with your feet. Inside the eight, you make contact. All right, if they back up, let them back up. Do not reach to try to stay with them to keep that contact. Respect their offense, let them move back, and just stay there and wait for them to come back at you. My name is that your temple, we were taught to kill the name. Mind genocide, perfect genocide, cleansing genocide, and blood is...
We're basically, I mean, we haven't really done any plays. We're just like working together really well. And just feeds from the back because they're not blowing us back there anymore. They were in the beginning. But everyone's wide open in the middle.
Hey, great match!
I thought we could do a lot better on the drill. I've only taken three, but I'm 3 for 3. But I mean, we could do a lot better on getting the ground balls and doing and drop controls just to make sure that they don't get the ball at all.
Whoever's on it.
Thought it went well. D coach hyped about the D performance, 9-2. Running through some plays, first real game of the year, looking good.
Competing against the Rockwall defense, McElhaney earns her first yellow card of the year. It's a slow walk to the sidelines.
We weren't really using our feet too much, but otherwise we were doing good zone.
What needs better work?
Just working on fouls, otherwise I don't think we
got it good.
Honestly enough, a win to win, but
win to win.
We have a lot to learn from this game.
Very sloppy. Yeah.
Room for
improvement.
Yes,
catch.
Let's go. Frisco! Thank you, Frisco. Thank you, Frisco.
Having lost the Texas State final game to Southlake, Frisco's next game has been marked on their calendar for months. With much to prove and a dose of confidence provided by coaches Kempsey and McCain, the team prepares for battle.
Yeah. What's your definition of success? I don't trust the thoughts that come inside my head. I don't trust this thing that beats inside my chest. Who I am and who I want to be cannot connect. Why? Don't think I deserve it, you get no respect. I just made a couple mils, still not impressed. Let you down goes triple platinum, yeah, okay, okay, I guess. Smile for a moment, then these questions starting to fill my head, not again. I push away the people that I love the most, why? I don't want no one to know I'm vulnerable, why? That makes me feel weak and so uncomfortable, why? Stop asking me questions, I just wanna feel alive until I die. This is an ace flow, just let me rhyme, I'm in disguise. I'm a busy person, got no time for lies. One of a kind, they don't see it, I pull out their eyes. I'm on a rise, I've been doing this for most of my life. And no advice, take my time.
Understanding the magnitude of the game, the Frisco Fury had the complete support of the lacrosse programs. The youth program showed in full force to support the team. High school varsity boys captain brought a team of supporters to keep the energy alive.
I'm Gavin Harmon, I'm a captain for the boys lacrosse team. Out here watching the girls game, playing against Southlake. Southlake always brings a good team to both boys and girls. It's going to be a good game.
I'm really nervous, but I'm excited to play, and I think we'll be able to pull it out, and we're going to cheer on our teammates and always have a positive attitude. And just try and win.
All right, everything you put in these entire season so far is for tonight. All right, this is a big game. Nothing's more important than this game play right now. All right, because we're going to play Frisco Curry Lacrosse. We are going to control what we can control. What we can control, our mouths and our attitude. I don't care if the ref calls something ridiculous. We do not say anything back. Just accept it because it's not going to change. Accept it and go five behind, four behind, or whatever they tell you. All right? Like I said, control, we can control. We're going to get calls against us. They're not going to be fair. Who cares? Just recover from it. All right? Play as hard as you can, 100% all the time. Support each other. Celebrate the little things. All right? Let's go.
Don't hit the goal. Don't hit the goal.
Frisco, 3-1-2-3.
Frisco!
Where are my goggles?
Switch on. Don't. We're all good at D, so let's down and then switch on. Okay, yeah.
Got it. I got ice in my veins, blood in my eyes, hate in my heart, love in my mind. I see nights full of pain. Days of sadness.
More careful with our passes and just keep the same still on the roll and slow down it on attack. Good defenses.
The problem is mostly on fast breaks. We don't know whether they're passing or shooting, so we don't know how to slide. But other than that,
in the first half, number 2 McElhaney takes her first yellow card and gets slightly injured in the process. The team now must be careful to avoid a second yellow card for McElhaney, which would remove her for the remainder of the game.
All right, that's the best first half of lacrosse that we played. Yeah. I'm not kidding. My goal was to keep, I didn't even say it out loud, it was to keep you guys under 2 the first half. So 1 is huge. All right, that's awesome. We need to keep up the energy on the field. Bench, awesome job at the end of the game. All right, we got to keep that up because it's translating onto the field.
These are that strong. Yeah. If we can get them down on attack, we can score. We're just trying to get them just keep not to get them on this side. That's the whole thing. Don't get them on that side. Yeah. Keep it on that side.
Defense,
well, you know.
Switch on defense. All they have
keep
is
it on that side. Not that side.
Sorry. You guys, 2 things. Well, actually, just 1 thing. on defense, I already told my low defenders this, but middies. 15 and 33 and 1, I think it is. They all have this kind of boy cradle. You can't really tell if they're gonna shoot or pass. They're gonna shoot. They've done it every time. They get the draw, fast break, fake a pass, then they shoot. We have to send girls. Just like how Natalie Howard did, fouled outside the 12, same thing. We do the drill every week in practice. 6-on-5 from the midfield. I want you guys putting pressure at the 15. Slow them down. If you foul them there, who cares?
Everybody being so pumped to, like, I don't know, sidelines are doing great, cheering us on, and everybody's talking and cheering everybody on. Great teamwork.
Well, we won against the Washington State Championship last year, and we're all super excited. We couldn't be more thrilled about the outcome of the game.
Alright, and we gotta focus on the most important part of the game, and that is the draw control. Okay, as soon as you start losing the draws, that's when that gap gets closer and closer and closer. Alright? Well, I am very, very proud of you guys.
Alright? I totally
love it. Yeah! Awesome. Awesome job, though. You guys should be proud of yourselves. Alright, it makes a huge difference when you have your teammates super excited for you and the entire game and pushing you to get to do something better and better and better. Alright, we're very proud of you. We will see you. We still have practice tomorrow.
You and I never die.
Welcome to D1, girls. Awesome job, Kim. I hope you guys know that we are very, very proud of you. Alright? We can use this game to get better because we're just going to hit better and better competition as the year goes on. Alright? But we know that they're not going to sleep tonight. We're going to sleep like babies. Alright?
Yeah!
COVID-19 brought the entire world to its knees, decimating the remainder of the 2020 season. Frisco Fury's aim of returning to the state tournament was lost in the process. And to the seniors, they lost their final season.
Good morning, seniors. I hope all is well with all y'alls. Hey, I'm sorry that the season ended the way it did. Things happen, but it was fun to watch you guys play as a team. Good luck with your future studies, and remember, you ladies are always champions.
I'm really bummed about how this year played out. I think, obviously, nothing that we can control, but I felt, and I'm sure I could say the same for the rest of the coaching staff, when we started coming in, even in the fall, that we felt like this was our year. We had a really strong group of girls across the whole program, but the seniors too, really special group. Really not ideal that it had to end this way, but we had a great year and a half, 2 years together, and I think we're lucky to have that time that we had together despite how things may have ended.
You know, just when you think that everything's, you know, finally coming along and these girls have built this strong unit that's ready to compete in the new D1, and then this global pandemic just sweeps in and just takes it all away from you, and it's not predictable, but it's definitely a tough pill to swallow, especially for these seniors that were looking forward to their last rodeo together, and you know, to celebrate them on senior night and all the hours that they put in and recognize them for getting the program where it is today. And you know, they're just not going to have that. They wake up one day to find out that it's just not happening, their season's just not going to continue, and you know, my heart breaks for the entire program. All these girls, you know, we had a really special team this year. And there was just so much passion, so much leadership from top to bottom, especially from those seniors. And you know, it was a really special group of girls that was going to go very far this season. And we might not have been there yet, but I think you all know that we were going to, you know, get there and be that group right when we needed to at the end of the season. And we were going to prove a lot of people wrong, and we were going to surprise a lot of people. And we had big things to prove this year, and we were going to do it. I know we were. We had the greatest team this year, and it really is a bummer, and you know, it's something that's going to sit in the back of our heads forever, just wondering, you know, what would have happened, what really would have happened at the end of the season. But at least, you know, we did have a couple games. We did get to start our season, so we have some positive things to look back at for the rest of our lives. You know, those bonds that we created this season and those friendships and all the memories and stuff, like those are the things that we will hang on to forever. And we just want you guys all to know how proud we are of you guys. And I know that we're a really tough coaching staff. And we always tell you how, you know, there's a nice win, but we're still not satisfied. And we're a hard group to please. But that's just because we knew how great you all were, and we wanted to squeeze all that greatness out of you guys. But we really were proud of you guys. And we want you to know that we love you all, and we are so proud of you. And we couldn't have asked for a better group of girls. And, you know, I'm very honored and proud to have coached you guys for these past two seasons, and get to work with some of you guys, even if, you know, you were brand new this year. Like, it's still a very special opportunity that we were given, and we appreciate every minute of it. But as far as our seniors, you know, this was your season. This was your year to put it all together. And I can't say it enough. I feel awful for you guys. But know that we are so proud of you, and we are so thankful for everything you've done for this entire program. And it's an honor to get to know you guys, and we're definitely going to follow you in the future, so we'll get to watch you do those big things we know you're going to do. So best of luck in the future, and to everyone else, you know, this fall, hopefully we have a season this fall and we have something to look forward to. But I miss you all, and hopefully we'll see you guys very soon. So go Fury!
The 2020 season is dedicated to the seniors. This is the first season that played from the inception of the girls lacrosse in Frisco to the final, although truncated, season. They set the foundation. It's time to build the house.
Losing my senior season is pretty sad, but I know that all things happen for a reason, so I'm just looking at the positives of everything.
I'm absolutely heartbroken about our spring season. Playing lacrosse is not only my passion, it's my life. I miss my coaches, my teammates, and fans cheering us on. However, I know that everything happens for a reason. Shout out to Varsity getting to play and beat South Lake. To my senior teammates, I wish you nothing but the best. And those playing college, I sure hope to play alongside you again or block all
year. Senior season kind of came as a shock because I'm not playing lacrosse in college, so I feel like I didn't get to properly say goodbye to the game or any of the relationships that I've built over the past 4 years.
Heartbroken how our senior season ended up happening, but I'm really proud of how we went out in the South Lake game and very thankful for my Fury.
Having my senior season taken away from me was probably the most devastating thing ever. I really wanted to make more memories with this team and was excited to play with other seniors and see what the underclassmen do. But I know I have all these past memories and that's what I'll cherish the most. And I just miss everyone so much and I wish I had a season.
With my senior lacrosse season being cut short, it kind of sucked because I didn't get to say goodbye to the people that I've been with for years and taught me so many things. And I was just excited for a senior season and hopefully getting a chance to win state.
Losing my season this year has been hard since it is my last year playing and being able to see all of my team in one place. But I will not forget them because of all the memories we've made together.
My senior season was really disappointing, but I'm thankful for all of the memories I've made with my Frisco Fury family, and I can't wait to see where lacrosse takes me in the future. I'm going to miss everybody so much.
I am really disappointed about our senior season, but I think I speak for a lot of the seniors when I say it's definitely not a subject I like to speak on, just because, you know, we were so confident going into the season and we did put so much work going into this spring season, and I was sure that this was going to be our year, as I'm sure we all were, and I think we were just kind of shocked whenever that was pulled out from under us. But like I said, it's definitely not a subject I love to talk about, just because I prefer to focus on everything that Frisco Fury has done for me throughout the years, throughout several different coaches, several different teammates. I wouldn't change a single experience I've had here for the world. And I love each and every teammate and coach and all of my competition, and I wouldn't change it for the world.
I think the most difficult part about losing my final high school season is never being able to play with my teammates again and never being able to be coached by Kayla or Claire, because we all grew so close over the years and now we won't ever get to play or do the same thing.
It was really hard waking up and seeing the email that said our entire senior season was canceled, because we didn't realize that any of our last times would be our last. Like, I've already put on my cleats for the last time and I didn't know it. I stepped onto the field for the last time and didn't realize that would be the last time I ever really played in a game.